Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios, Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, Top Corner Kurt on Instagram. Thanks for watching. As I was making my own NHL team for the 2017-18 season, I couldn't help but notice how many terrific young hockey players there are in the NHL. There were so many, in fact, that I had to restrict myself to just two players on their entry-level contracts while building my team. Otherwise, it would have been too easy to construct a team to keep under the $75 million NHL salary cap. So what I've decided to do to show you how many terrific, young, inexpensive players there are in the NHL is I'm making a team made up entirely of players who are on their entry-level contract for the 2017-18 season. My only stipulation this time is that they must have played at least one game in the NHL. So players who are on their entry-level deals and are still in junior or the American Hockey League, players like Thomas Chabot, I can't choose them. We'll do the same thing as we did before. I'll pick 22 players, 2 goalies, 7 defensemen, and 13 forwards. Let's start in goal. All right, my number one goalie is Tristan Jarry. The second-round pick of the Penguins made his NHL debut against the Rangers in April of 2017. Jarry lost, but I'm sure he'll get his first NHL win soon. He's been great in the American Hockey League, winning 28 games with a 2.15 goals against and a super 925 save percentage in 2016-17. My backup is Eric Comrie. Winnipeg's second-rounder from 2012 has played one NHL game, which he won on April 6th, 2017 over Columbus. Comrie has spent the last 2 years in the American League with the Manitoba Moose. He's managed to keep his save percentage above 9, despite playing on a very weak team. My first defense pairing is Noah Hanifin and Zach Werenski. Hanifin was picked 5th overall by the Carolina Hurricanes in 2015. He's kind of been torched a bit in his first 2 seasons while playing for a lousy team, but he certainly did improve from his rookie year to his sophomore year. I see no reason at all that his 3rd year in the NHL, Hanifin, won't continue to trend upwards. And Werenski, what else can we say about him? He was a surprise finalist for the Calder Trophy in 2017. He scored 47 points as a 19-year-old for the Blue Jackets. Not too many teenagers make the NHL look as easy as Werenski did in his first year. My second pairing begins with Ivan Provorov. The former Brandon Wheat King was picked 7th overall in 2015. Provorov did not look out of place in his rookie year, scoring 30 points while playing 22 minutes a game. He's Philadelphia's future anchor. Along with him is Josh Morrissey. And like Provorov, Morrissey is another former dubber as Morrissey played for the Prince Albert Raiders. Morrissey played almost 20 minutes a game and was a plus player on a Jets team that suffered defensively in 2016-17, although it was mostly goaltending. He'll score more than 30 points, I betcha, in 2017-18. My bottom pairing begins with Jacob Slavin, or is it Jakob? Either way, drafted in the 4th round of 2012, Slavin looks like a great steal after just 2 seasons in the NHL. He's smart, fast, and hard on the puck. I think he'll score 50 points for the Hurricanes in 2017-18. Carolina likes him so much they've already locked up the 23-year-old to a 7-year deal worth over $5 million a season starting next year. With him is Florida's Michael Matheson. He made Team Canada for the 2016 World Hockey Championships with only 3 games of NHL experience, and he scored 6 points in 10 games while going plus 11 in that tournament. He played his first full NHL season with the Panthers last year, picking up 17 points and playing nearly 20 minutes a game. Darnell Nurse will be my 7th defenseman. He's big and strong, but I think that's where it ends for him. I don't believe the hype that Nurse will become a top 4 defenseman, but he's good enough to make my ELC team. Let's get to the meat of my team, the forwards. Starting with my top line, my left winger is Max Domi. After a real nice rookie year, Domi struggled to stay healthy in 2016-17, but there's no question Domi has speed, creativity, and possesses a great shot. No surprise here, Connor McDavid is my number one center. Some already think he's the best player in the world. I don't think so, but he's a fantastic player and almost certainly will become, very soon, the best player in the world. With great speed, McDavid's got a lot of moves, and he single-handedly resurrected the Oilers in just 1 season. About this time next year, McDavid will be making over $13 million a season. On the right side, I've got Mitch Marner. Just like Domi and McDavid, Marner has super speed, and he's crafty with the puck. He has a lot of guts for a small, skilled guy, too. He doesn't play on the perimeter. Marner will get the puck and make a smart play with it. My second line left winger is Nikolai Ehlers. He racked up 25 goals while playing on one of the best lines in the NHL in 2016-17. I think he'll do even better with the guys I've got him playing with. His center is Austin Matthews. Matthews is big, has a great shot, and Mario Lemieux-like patience. Matthews has the ability to hold on for that split second longer than 99% of other players. That vision allows him to pick his spots. On the right side, Patrick Laine. Wouldn't it be something to have Matthews and Laine on the same line? Well, here we go. Laine scored 36 goals last year, including 3 hat tricks. He could turn out to be a streaky scorer like Phil Kessel in the future, or he could become another dynamite scorer like Alex Ovechkin. On the left side of my third line, I have Sebastian Aho. Dude scored 24 goals and 49 points and finished 8th for the Calder. Tough break for the former 35th overall pick. Aho sure looks like he'll be a very consistent player for the Hurricanes for many years. My third line center is Jack Eichel. He missed 22 games in 2016-17 and still improved on his rookie scoring season. Plus, Eichel led the Sabres in scoring too. Eichel could be the Sabres' point leader for the next 10 years. My third line right winger is William Nylander. One of the best shots in the NHL, and he's not afraid to try things either. I like that. Nylander is money in the bank on the power play with 10 of his career 28 NHL goals coming with the man advantage. My fourth line begins with Matthew Tkachuk. He plays like his old man. He can score, but he can also punch you in the face. He's a welcome breath of fresh air in this often suffocating and overprotective current version of the NHL. Any team would be lucky to have Tkachuk. At center is Sam Reinhart. Although drafted second overall in 2014, it seems to me Sam Reinhart is invisible. I know Buffalo sucks, but he scored 40 goals in his first 2 seasons, 23 of those goals coming on the power play. And my fourth line right winger is Mikko Rantanen. There's a big part of me that really wanted to take Ryan Hartman here, but I picked Rantanen because of his size. The big Finn is 6'4", 220 pounds, for heaven's sakes. I was 6 feet, 150 when I was Rantanen's age. Anyway, Mikko is more than just a big kid. He scored 20 goals for the Colorado Crapalanche in 2016-17. This means I'll take Ryan Hartman as my 13th forward. He scored 19 goals for the Hawks last year while playing only 13 minutes a game. He's a great, underrated young player. My entry-level contract team, 22 players, cost me just over $19 million. I'm nowhere near the salary cap floor of $55.4 million for 2017-18 season. I was surprised as I was picking my team that only 9 players on my team are making max ELC money of $925,000 a season. I really like my forwards on this team. I mean, my team combined to score almost 300 goals in 2016-17, and there's no doubt they'll score more than that in this upcoming season as a combined unit. On defense, obviously, it's very young, but I do have some players like Josh Morrissey and Jakub Slavin that I'm really excited about. I think those are the 2 best defenders that I have on my team. I would say my weakest link for sure is in goal. It was really hard to find goalies that had NHL experience on their entry-level contracts. I think Tristan Jarry will be a pretty good goalie in the NHL. I certainly think he's got a higher ceiling than Eric Comrie. So what do you think of my entry-level contract team? It was a pretty fun exercise. It does show, it proves, how many terrific players there are in the NHL on entry-level contracts. It was really easy to build this team. I didn't have to do a lot of searching because there are so many great familiar players out there on their first 3-year contract. Unlike my last list, there's not a whole lot left for interpretation here, but were there any players, young players on their ELCs you think I missed? But of course, I'm still interested to find out your opinions and your comments. Let me know as you watch this video. Please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.